past 4 o'clock and we're in trouble deep. Wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie.
Well,
what are we gonna tell your mama? What are we gonna tell your pa? What are we gonna tell your friends when they say, ooh la la, wake up, little Susie. Wake up, little Susie.
Well, I told your mama I'd have you home by 10. Oh, Susan, I look like we could begin.
Wake up, little Susie. We gotta go.
Come what may. what's occurred here is Sean and I made a record together. And we're pretty proud of it. And I think they've got them at all the merch locations in the vicinity. Check it out. And God knows there aren't any more fucking record stores to speak of. That song is on it that we just played, and we wrote that. And this song is on it, and we didn't write it.
When I woke up this morning, you were on my mind. You were on my mind. I got troubles, whoa. I got worries, whoa. I got wounds to hide.
Most of this record, but there are some covers. That's one, and this is another one, and Sean will tell you about it.
Yeah, we wrote six of the songs for this record. We covered four songs, all songs that we just had to sing. Couldn't wait to, and that last one was it. Song was he and Sylvia did it. Sylvia wrote it. This is a song by one of my very favorite writers. You might not think of her. She's a great friend of this festival. You might not think of her as one of your favorite writers because she came up in our world covering mostly other people's tunes and began to write more and more as her career went on. And she's fabulous. And we're very proud today to do a song written by Emmy Lou Harris.
Hank Williams died when I was five. Said I'll never get out of this world alive. And now it's been a long time since I was that kid. And I've seen a lot more than Hank ever did. I've done the down and out in every day.
to your love alive. And Sam Cooke met the woman at the well. She told him that his song was something he could never sell, and I think he knew change was gonna come. Still he lived too fast and he died too young. Well, I'm dying young, I have survived, and I'll never get out of your love alive. And I got washed in the blood of Mill Monroe when he sang about the blues in the body and soul. Believed in a God that could raise the dead. It's a mighty dark road to travel, he said. I seen a mighty dark night and I made that drive, and I'll never get out of your love alive. Robert Johnson had a hellhound on his trail. Drove him to the coffin like a hammer and a nail. It takes a powerful man to carry that load. Trying to beat the devil to the old crossroad. Well, I wrestled the devil, lived to testify, but I'll never get out of your love alive. Get out of your love alive. Well, I'll never get out of your love alive.
Thanks. So much. Here we go. These the covers on this record are largely about fantasy camp. Which means, you know, we just songs we just had to sing. This one, for instance, I'm reasonably sure I learned to play tennis racket actually, with this record on the turntable in front of a mirror, and switched over to guitar shortly thereafter.
She would never say where she came from. Yesterday don't matter if it's gone. While the sun is bright or in the darkest night, no one knows. She comes and goes. Lost. was your Christ.
That one, and Sean brought this one.
If I could plug in my guitar, it'd be good, but that's gonna help a lot. There we go. This is a song that came out of that great decade, my decade, say what you will, the 60s. And, oh boy. And in the 60s, this particular song was done by a group called the Nashville Teens, which is a great name. However, of course, they were from England. And here it goes.
Bring dynamite and a crane. show. Give the name of Tobacco Road, but it's home. The only life I've ever known, and only you know how low. Tobacco Road. Home, the only life I've ever known, and only you know how I love tobacco.
Thank you so much. So when we started writing songs for this record, we were actually doing a tour together that was sort of a, you know, us being each other's special guests, a tour where I'd sing a song. We were on stage together the whole time, but I'd sing a song, Sean would sing a song. We sang some songs together, but and we got the idea from the songs that we sang together that maybe we should make a record. And during that tour, we took one couple of day break to write some songs in Nashville, and we wrote a song in two thirds. And then we got together a few months later. Of course, by that time we'd gone our separate ways on our separate tours. So some of this was written on phones. I mean, you know, the technology is what it is, but it was like I've discovered I do not text accurately or quickly enough to be single in this day and age, but it works okay for songwriting. Because when you're writing a song, it doesn't matter if you sing the wrong text to the wrong girl. But we did actually get together in the same room a couple of times. The next time was in Austin at Sean's house. And we finished the two-thirds of a song and wrote another song. And then got together a final time in New York City. And if you're looking out my front window in New York and you kind of lean out, down to your left, because I'm on the fourth floor, you can see right where Fred Neil was standing on the cover of Bleeker and McDougal. And those of you that don't know who Fred was, he wrote Everybody's Talking, and he wrote this mind-blowing song called The Dolphins that I've still not recovered from hearing for the first time. So, this is Sean's melody that she brought in kind of fully formed, but for some reason, maybe it's just geography. Every time we do this, I feel very much haunted by Fred Neil.
Walking upward, my feet to the fire, the way that I
Sometimes we feel the need to point out that that's a love song. It's
a little dysfunctional, so that's why we point it out. But
they say write what you know. But this is a love song as well, but it's even more fucked up than that last one.
Remember that sound. Don't remember who put
so right. I'm wrong. I knew all along. I'm wrong. You're right. I miss you tonight. You're right. I'm wrong. I knew all along.
Walmart down. I'm thinking about
Thanks a lot. That's always been one of my favorite Steve Earle songs. And when we first started touring together a couple years ago, I specifically asked that he play that one. Not realizing really at the time that there was kind of a perfect segue into a song of mine, Should We Do Burning It Down? Because I have my own arson song. And wouldn't really peg me for it, but it's true. I'm kind of a writer of sad, depressing breakup songs, but yeah, people seem to like it. I keep doing it. But I actually managed to make this arson song into a breakup song, too. So,
genius.
And Steve said to me, this is huge. He said, this may be the ultimate breakup song.
It's a fucking murder ballad.
It is a fucking murder ballad, and it sure was fun to write. Came home to her favorite room. Sunny sat down in the kitchen. She opened a book and a box of tools. Sunny came home with a mission. She says, days go by. Sunny came home with a list of names. She didn't believe in transcendence. And it's time for a few small repairs, she said. And Sunny came home with a vengeance. She says, days go by. Sunny came home. came home. She came home. Came home.
Sean Colvin.
Thank you so much. Steve's got out this cute and magnificent and tiny little instrument.
Ronnie McCurry says that playing a small instrument makes you look big. But I reckon there's several issues at work there. But this is my favorite thing I own in the world. This last divorce, I was determined to get out of with this fucking mandolin, if nothing else. And I did manage that. This song started with a, this was the two-thirds of a song that took us a while to finish. It started with a mandolin riff of mine, and it was Tell Moses. It was always called Tell Moses. I don't know why some songs just come with titles, and the only way I know to explain that is I've traveled to Israel several times in the last few years, and it's, the reason I did that was because I was invited by a gentleman named David Brosa, who in Israel is me, Bruce Springsteen, and a bag of chips. He's a singer and a songwriter and an activist. And he invited me. He wanted to make a record with a half Israeli, half Palestinian band in a Palestinian-owned studio in East Jerusalem. And I couldn't pass. He wanted me to produce it. I couldn't pass that up because I'm not afraid of Roger Waters, and I'd never been to Jerusalem. So. But when you, there's a great film called East Jerusalem, West Jerusalem about the making of that record. It went on Netflix about a week ago. East Jerusalem, West Jerusalem on Netflix. Check it out. But anyway, you go to a place like that, it can't help but you start thinking in Old Testament terms. So it was Tell Moses, the first verse, fuck all we could do about it was Exodus, nothing we could do. Second verse, largely Sean's, we got into this thing about Martin Luther King, and it was like, we thought, okay, we need one more leader and we can finish a song about leaders. We can ship this puppy. But we never came up with that third leader and we kept trying. And finally it occurred to us that maybe what this song was really about is things, when things really change in this world, it's based on what we as individuals do from the time we wake up in the morning till we go to bed every single day of our lives. So when it comes time to sing, sing, or everybody will think you're Republicans. And if you are Republicans, everybody will know you were here.
Talking about the trouble with the Israelites. Now how am I supposed to build this monument of mine if I can keep the monoliths moving down the line? Tell Moses, tell him go, say the children of Israel are suffering. So tell Moses, tell him true, you gotta lead him where the Pharaoh won't be following you. Water is wine, milk and honey on the other side. Water is wine, milk and honey on the other side. Water is wine, milk and honey on the other side. Keep on traveling along. Gotta stick together.
together if we're gonna stay alive. Ride guaranteed, gas sheriffs on the edge, waiting with an army over yonder across the bridge. Tell Martin, tell him go. Say the governor's in Montgomery and you gotta let him know. Tell Martin, tell him now. Hey, it's been up on the mountain and he's gotta show us how. Cause water is white and milk and honey on the other side. Water is white and milk and honey on the other side. Water is wide, milk and honey on the other side. Keep on traveling along.
That's your part now. Water is white, milk and honey on the other side. Water is white, milk and honey on the other side. Water is white, milk and honey on the other side.
It's your turn.
Come on. Water is white, milk and honey on the other side. Ferguson, Missouri, people in the streets. Hands above their heads, standing up to the police. Waiting on a hero to step into the breach. Ain't nobody coming, so it's up to you and me. Tell Mary, tell John. Say the hourglass is empty and the judgment day has come. Tell preacher, Farmer Brown. Say Joshua's blowing his trumpet and the walls are coming down. Tell sister, brother too. Tell them where they're gonna meet us and what we're gonna do. Tell Stephen, tell Sean. There's a message in the music, everybody sing along.
Water is white, milk and honey on the other side.
Water is white, milk and honey on the other side.
Keep on traveling along.
Good singing.
Thanks, you guys. We're going to close out the program here. This is the song that closes our record. And it's a three-way co-write. It was a verse and music and melody were given to me by a ridiculously amazing songwriter named Julie Miller. And if you don't know who Julie is, you might know of her husband, Buddy Miller, who produced our record, by the way. So, yeah, he's kind of he's a big, you know, he's here a lot. So Julie gave me a verse and some music and gave it to me. She doesn't need anybody to finish her songs, but she was generous enough to let me have a go at finishing it. I let it be for a while, kind of waiting for the right time to come up, which happened to be on April 1st of 2014, because my dear dad passed away then, and this was the song that I knew I needed to have, and it needed me, and that was the thing to do. And unbeknownst to me, Julie had written that verse that she gave me about her brother, who she lost, so we were on the same page, and it's obviously a song about loss. It wasn't done though, and I wanted Steve to help with finishing it, so when we got together in Austin, I asked him what he thought should come next.
And so Julie wrote the first verse, Sean wrote the second verse, and I wrote the choruses, and loss is pretty universal, so it was pretty easy to hook into, and since we finished the song, we lost Guy Clark, and he was one of the greatest songwriters ever walked this planet, and we've been singing it for Guy.
Every time the rain comes in, every time I hear the wind, I can hear your voice again.
looks like you. Every color turns to blue. No one knows what I've come to. Alone here in the dark. When I close my eyes, the silence never lies. It's then I realize you're still gone. Sometimes I can sing a song. Sometimes I know right from wrong. I can see where I belong, like sailboats on the lake. Dreamed you came back in the air to fix my leaky roof again. Where you had been, I found myself away. And I'm still all alone, and it chills me to the bone. But I keep going on, and you're still gone. Still gone. And the world keeps spinning. Still gone, you're still gone, and I don't know what I'm waiting on. I depended on you for so long.
Sean Colvin,
Steve Earle. Thank you, everybody. You want to say something about the Black Panther?
No.
Have a great time. Thank you.
Colvin and Earle. If you like that, you will love their new record, Colvin and Earle. It's available at this merch booth and all the merch booths. And as I've been saying all day, support the artists.